We're back at the NRA National Firearms Museum with Phil Schreier, Senior Curator of the National Firearms Museum, for another installment of the Curator's Corner. Phil, we're here in the Ruger Gallery because Hollywood Guns is going on now at the National Firearms Museum. Fantastic display of new and old Hollywood firearms memorabilia. The Maltese Falcon is right over there, which is really cool and just neat stuff. And but the center of this is the guns. It's the Hollywood guns, and we're featuring some of these on Curator's Corner. So tell us what you have for us this week.
Well, John, thanks again for having us on the show, as always. We've got the standard, beautiful Walther PPK. And what character says
James Bond?
Obviously. For as many Bond films as there have been, there's a cable channel now that just shows Bond all the time.
Wow. By the way, Phil, how do I get that cable channel?
This was used by Timothy Dalton,
okay,
who appeared as Agent 007 in two films.
Right.
PPK he used in License to Kill,
1989.
It's like all the other Bond PPKs. It's opening credits. You're looking down the rifling of the
right
barrel.
Man.
Yeah, I wonder how many people that actually watch all those Bond films and maybe don't know much about guns at all have no clue what they're looking at.
Right.
In the opening credits.
What's that?
Rifling, from a barrel.
It's a tunnel? What is it?
Oh, and why is it always in every open? Get with the program. Anyway, the PPK. The neat thing about this gun is that films are made, all these guns were rented from different prop houses.
Right.
There is no James Bond traveling prop wagon that goes from film to film. In fact, after this film, which wasn't very successful commercially, it was quite a while before another Bond film came out. These get rented over and over again to the prop master, the studio warehouse. They used to attach little or no interest to the fact that Timothy Dalton used this,
right,
or Sean Connery or whoever. Now that interest is there, and so they're paying attention to that. But this would go back in a drawer and get rented again the minute it was available. So the neat thing about this is that it was rented. It was rented for the first season of a detective show that was making its debut.
Right.
And used by our very own Tom Selleck.
Really?
In the very first season of Magnum P.I.
I didn't know
so,
that.
So, yeah.
That's too cool. That's so truly a Hollywood gun.
Double duty.
It's done television. It's done films.
That's right.
That is something else. Wow.
So we have a fantastic. Now, like I said, these are real guns, but they've seen a lot of use. And the guys in Hollywood that have been running guns as early as the silent, films were getting going. Stembridge was established in 1915. They rented guns to D.W. Griffith for Birth of a Nation. The care for historical artifacts wasn't present. To them, it was a tool of the trade. It was it was merchandise. And so, as you can see here, this gun's been completely re-blued. They would go out on a set, whether or not, the gun was damaged or not. They come back in, it was scratched up. Oh, just re-blew it, put a new set of grips on, whatever.
Ready to go.
But there are some real classic gems of firearms we're going to see in next week's episode of real antique treasures that survived rough usage out in the fields and the sets.
Now, I just saw another Bond film. That's why this is great timing, as usual, Phil, on this, where was the Sean Connery one where they had him start to use that gun for the first time. They want him to get rid of it. I can't remember what his other firearm was. He very reluctantly gave it up, and they gave him the PPK. And it's like, a Beretta he had.
Oh,
and it was like, and just that was born right there, was the famous Bond Walther PPK connection.
You would wonder because, he's so... so British, you know, well, the British automatic pistols are some of the ugliest guns ever manufactured in history. I mean, the Webley and Scott, it's a gigantic right angle brick with a hole in it. Works, but as with most British firearms, with the exception of their sporting guns and double rifles, it's always function over form.
Right.
With their military stuff. So they want to, they'd almost have to go to a foreign pistol.
Right.
But the PPK, I've always thought Bond would look best with a Mauser HSC.
Oh.
That would be classic.
Well, the good one about that, it's elegant and small, and it slips into a tuxedo very well.
Oh,
because that's 9 times out of 10. He uses it with a tuxedo.
And you get white before Labor Day and black
Of course. And of course. Now, tell us how folks can come and see this particular farm and this wonderful display here in person or on your website.
John, if you're traveling around the Washington metropolitan area, we're just 12 miles away from the city of Washington off of Interstate 66 in Fairfax, Virginia, the intersection of 66 and Route 50. We're open 7 days a week from 9:30 to 5. With the exception of a few federal holidays, we're open 7 days a week. Free admission, plenty of parking. If you can't make it to the museum personally, you can visit us 24 hours a day online at NRAMuseum.com. And please check out that website. It is a thing of wonderment. It is just amazing. You can actually see the guns on the website closer than you can in real life.
Wow.
Because the photography that's been done on capturing every gun in the collection, you can zoom in and see things that you can't get that close to through the glass.
And as we were discussing before we went on the air here, on your website, we were a few months ago, we were out shooting some video at the Tulsa Arms Show, the Wanamaker Tulsa Arms Show, for a new program we're getting ready to debut on the National Firearms Museum site called On the Road, where we followed you and Jim Sapieca out into the field, and you guys got up there and took all comers, and we're talking about firearms, what it was, what it wasn't, what it was worth, is it worth anything, and we've got it all ready to go. So look at the National Firearms Museum, go there, check it out, and there'll be information how you can see that program as well.
Great, yeah, we can't wait to see that.
Phil, thank you very much for another wonderful peek at a Hollywood gun here on the Curator's Corner.
Thank you, John.